if you've been to New Orleans before, you are going to be so excited with who I'm talking to tonight. We are at the Maple Leaf, and we are speaking with the legendary John Cleary. I know you come from London. Tell me,
a long time ago, yeah.
Tell me how you got here.
I came here straight after I left school. I always loved New Orleans music as a kid. And everybody, you know, a lot of musicians in the family, and everybody loved all kinds of different black American music, basically, and a lot of New Orleans jazz and New Orleans rhythm and blues. And it resonated with me. And when my uncle, who had lived in New Orleans, came back, he was always telling all these stories. And to me, it sounded like the most exotic place in the world. Pirates, funk, R&B, alligators, swamps, all the whole kit and caboodle. For a little kid, it was very evocative, you know. So I thought, man, as soon as I can go, I'm going. And so my mum and dad said, yeah, I could go after I left school. And I was coming for a couple of weeks. And I'm still here 30-something years later. I think if they'd known I was going to be here this long, they would never would have let me go. But it's amazing. They let me come when they did. They were very hip. And when I came here, I would made a point of seeking out all the musicians whose names I recognized from the record labels, and I would ask them a lot of questions, and they thought it was kind of interesting because at that point New Orleans wasn't hip or wasn't well known about, but they were very, very kind, and they were flattered that a youngster from another country was interested. And so I got a lot of information. I bought all as many records as I could. I'd spend hours at home playing the piano and learning and listening. What they did here in New Orleans changed the way people around this country played music, and changed music around the world. This is where jazz started. And people always are familiar with New Orleans jazz. And a lot of people think it's kind of old-timey stuff. But the roots of that evolved through the generations, passed down from one generation to the next, and continued to evolve. It didn't just stay that. It became rhythm and blues. And rhythm and blues here in New Orleans had been around for a long, long time before it got labeled rock and roll. Everybody's heard of rock and roll. But this is where rock and roll came from, too. Rhythm and blues and rock and roll. Before that, New Orleans jazz. Before that, African music. And you absorb all that stuff, and then you try and do something new with it. So when you come see my band, you're going to get a taste of all New Orleans music, but it's also my stamp on it, how I see it coming through my filter. We all have the blues. There's a lot of rotten stuff that happens. And we've had some stuff here in New Orleans that happened in recent history that was really, really bad. But here in New Orleans, they don't get miserable. They celebrate the good things. And that's what we do. Every time we sit down to play, we make a joyful noise. That's the whole idea.
John, thank you so much. If this interview has not excited you to get up and go out and see this man play and hear some music here in New Orleans, I don't know what can. This has been fascinating and amazing.
Yeah, if you're checking out real New Orleans music, played real good. Not, I mean, I do my thing, but I always get the best musicians. That's the one talent I have is I hire the hippest cats.
This has been great. Thank you so much. And thanks for supporting live music. See you around New Orleans. Come see John play.